Hello everyone! In this tutorial, I'm going to show you how to make this oil paint effect in Photoshop. After following this tutorial, you will create your own oil paint effect PSD file. And by using this file, you will be able to reapply the same effect on any new image with a single click. Please like the video and let's get started. Step 1. Create the effect. Let's start by creating a new document. Set width to 3000 pixels, height to 2000 pixels, with 300 resolution and RGB color mode. Then click Create. Now go to File, Place Embedded to import your image. Just select the image you like and click on Place. Resize your image as you want, then press Enter. Now I want to remove these areas to avoid any problems in step 3. I will do so by pressing Ctrl and A to make a full canvas selection. And with the layer selected, go and create a mask from here. Right-click the layer and convert it to a smart object. If you press Ctrl and T, you will find that your new smart object has the same document dimensions like that. Now select your layer, then go to Image, Adjustments, and choose Shadows and Highlights. As you can see here, by moving the shadow slider, all highlights areas will be brighter. And also, by moving the highlight slider, all highlights areas will get darker. Only need to increase shadows to 25 and highlights to 5, then click OK. Now select your layer and let's apply the oil paint filter from here. Change it to 7, 5, 7, and 5. Also, make sure that lighting is checked. Change the angle to anything you want, and set shine to 0.3. And here is the result. Click OK to submit, and let's continue. Now go to Filter, Sharpen, and activate the Smart Sharpen filter. Change amount to 100, radius to 10, reduce noise to 100, and remove to lens blur. This will sharpen your image and boost the overall details, plus reduce the noise to its minimum value. Now let's go to Filter, Blur, Surface Blur. Change amount to 20 pixels with 10 threshold. And this will make your effect smoother by wiping away some skin details. Finally, go to the Filter Gallery. And inside the Brush Strokes folder, choose the Accented Edges filter. Change it to 1, 28, and 1. This will accentuate the edges of your image with some glowing lines. Before moving to the next step, let's hear from our today's sponsor. Skillshare is a huge online learning platform with thousands of premium classes for all creative and curious people. They have thousands of inspiring classes about graphic design, photography, illustration, filmmaking, freelancing, and much more. They offer almost 3,000 classes about Photoshop only. One class that I really like is the Photoshop Advanced Training Course from Daniel Scott. He has almost 14 hours of premium content for this class only. Unlike YouTube, Skillshare is 100% free of ads, so you can stay focused and follow wherever your creativity takes you. And for the first 1,000 people who join Skillshare from the link in my description, we'll get a 1-month free trial of Skillshare Premium membership. Join Skillshare to boost your creativity today. Now let's get back to our tutorial. Let's select our layer again, then go to Filter, Noise, Add Noise Filter. Change amount to 1 and click OK. Then go to Filter, Other, and choose High Pass. Change it to 2 pixels and click OK. Double-click on the High Pass filter's little icon to open its blending options. Change the blending mode to Overlay and click OK. I always use the High Pass filter with Overlay to sharpen the final details of my effects. Finally, let's go to the Filter Gallery again. Inside the Texture folder, choose the Texturizer filter. Change texture type to Sandstone, scaling to 50%, and relief to 3, then click OK. This will add something like paper texture to your final effect. And here is the before and after. Now let's move on to the next step. Step 2. Add tone and adjustment layers. First, let's delete this background layer with a delete key. Duplicate your layer with Ctrl and J. And right-click the smart filters and choose Clear Smart Filters to remove them. Double-click your layer's name to rename it to Effect. And duplicate the top layer again with Ctrl and J. Rename one of them, Before, and drag it to the bottom. And rename the other layer, Tone, and leave it on the top. And with a tone layer selected, go to Filter, Blur, Gaussian Blur. Change radius to 10 pixels, then click OK. Create an invert layer and a black and white layer. And with a top layer selected, hold the Shift key and select all three layers. Press Ctrl and G to group them. Rename it Tone Opacity. And finally, change the group blending mode to Overlay. Just control this tone by decreasing the group opacity like that. For this particular image, 25% gives me a good result. And here is the result. Finally, you can create some adjustment layers and leave them to be used wherever you want. Now let's move on to the final step. Step 3. Update the effect with a single click. First, let's save this project as a PSD file from here for any future use. Now I want to update this existing image without repeating all previous steps. Just double-click on the Smart Objects thumbnail to open it. Once you're inside the Smart Object, go and import your new image from here. Resize it as you want, then press Enter. Now press Ctrl and S. Get back to your main document. And here we go. Let's see how to configure it for a better result. I forgot to mention that if you want to get a dark skin tone, you can hide this invert layer, then control the tone by changing the group opacity like that. Of course, it depends on your choice. Also, you can play with the adjustment layers to get a better result of your effect. That's it for today. Please like the video and subscribe for more free tutorials. Thanks for watching.